Taking one last look at the team, a refresher here. Annihilate with Night Slash has been the key for Doonbug. Not only is he playing at an incredibly high level, but somehow he's also getting these very small percentage chances to go even further. Double boosting Boostbug, as we're going to call him, right, has just been unstoppable. And Magic Mason is the last thing standing in his way.
Double boosting not once, but twice. That's four times the boosting power. And on the other side, Magic Mason's team, Shadow Gligar, has been so pivotal for him. No ice types on the side for Doonbug, so feeling probably very safe to bring it in these matchup. Game number one, grand finals, everything on the line.
Now, imagine Mason said Doonbug read him like a book, but Doonbug is going to turn the page to the next scene because we've got a Lickitung versus Whiscash after a dominant Chargebug into Skarmory lead.
And we had seen in the previous matchup, Magic Mason sacrificing a Whiscash into double super effective power up, getting the attack drop from the Scald makes this matchup a little bit more close.
Lickitung going to gear up for a Power Whip here after the Scald debuff. You've seen the debuffs and the impact they can have in the matchup. Double super effective or not, this might not be enough, but Magic Mason doesn't want to find out. He's going to use that first Protect Shield of the game.
Going up towards another Scald. Question becomes, will Magic Mason fight for switch advantage, or will he just go for doing a lot of damage to this Lickitung? Second Scald coming through, pulls a second attack drop.
Lickitung slows down even more in this matchup as the second Scald does connect. Looking for a third Scald here. Mudbomb may or may not have been enough, but Doonbug using his first Protect Shield of the matchup. Another 3-for-3 Scald debuffs, and Lickitung is barely moving an inch at this point.
And we were he was talking about earlier, can he get the debuffs in his favor? 3-for-3 sure seems like it, holding on, but also switching out, had the opportunity to reach for a Mudbomb, pivoting into Skarmory, now faced up against Chargebug.
Magic Mason trying to wiggle free of a very tough alignment situation, but finds the Chargebug on the opposite end. Doonbug pinning him here in a tough matchup will not let him go.
Skarmory building up energy towards the Brave Bird. This would be a lot of neutral damage. One shield still on Doonbug's side. Does he shield and farm down?
Incredible shield call here by Doonbug as he throws up his final Protect Shield of the matchup against the Skarmory. Two Volt Switches get the knockout, and now he's got a weakened Whiscash. He does not know the third Pokemon, but out comes the Whiscash, and the Mudbomb gets fired off immediately.
Good timing from Magic Mason here. One Mudshot into the Mudbomb to do a lot of chip damage into the Chargebug, putting it down into the yellow, but Doonbug able to farm down with Volt Switch.
Chargebug chewing through these Pokemon from Magic Mason, gears up for the X Scissor against the opposing Chargebug here. And Magic Mason has to be feeling like he's fading in this game number one because Doonbug hasn't even revealed his third Pokemon yet.
Chargebug charging up, charging through this other Chargebug. How many times can I say the word charge in a sentence?
Hey, chugga chugga choo choo, all aboard the Chargebug train. Here comes an X Scissor and a swap onto Lickitung. If the gap wasn't already large enough, it got even wider.
And even with the help of Scald debuffs on his side, Magic Mason is just in such a tough spot here. Great charge attack timing from Doonbug, throwing after two licks to ensure that the Volt Switch damage does not apply before the Body Slam goes through.
Body Slam weakens the Chargebug, and Doonbug makes a very high-level play to send his own Chargebug, not even revealing the third Pokemon to Magic Mason. So not only does Magic Mason go down early in the series, he doesn't even know what Doonbug's whole team was.
And I think Caleb pointed out game number 5 of their first series in the Winners Finals was heavily one-sided, and we see that once again here in the first game of the Grand Finals, Doonbug looking absolutely unstoppable.
Doonbug, Magic Mason, two former regional champions and worlds competitors squaring off here in Knoxville. As you look at game number one, a few key moments, but I think most of the story was told by Doonbug's fantastic line prediction.
And I was a bit surprised to see Magic Mason put so much into this Whiscash, let the power up go through, and then switch out afterwards before trying to knock out the Lickitung with a Mudbomb.
Mudbomb into Chargebug wasn't quite enough, but our trainers are queued up here for a game number 2 of our grand finals in Knoxville. We've got the famous Shadow Gligar for Magic Mason lined up against Lickitung for Doonbug.
And we've seen Magic Mason pilot this flying type so well into neutral matchups. Lickitung, Cresselia, he's won them all.
Lickitung goes for the body slam early on in the matchup against the Shadow Gligar. Shadow Gligar typically is a great safe switch for Magic Mason, but because of some of the obstacles here, right, the Whiscash, the Skarmory, he doesn't feel that comfortable switching it in, so he's going to throw it in the lead here, throw a dig at the Lickitung, and this will connect.
And this has been the key factor in winning those neutral matchups, getting a dig through and allowing himself to only go for Aerial Ace afterwards in order to pressure shields off of his opponents. Doonbug, however, recognizing this is only an Aerial Ace, if I no shield it here, I can get another body slam off and threaten shield advantage.
It's just fascinating the resilience of these trainers as we see the Skarmory switch in into the mirror match. Two Skarmories on both of these teams, Phoebe. We saw Charjabug on both teams in game number one, and they are still bringing their Skarmories into this matchup.
It blows my mind. Magic Mason once again safe swapping Skarmory in the face of a potential Charjabug. This time, however, it pays off, and in the back, the Dugong is looking pretty good into Whiscash, but it will become, once again, a game of debuffs.
Charge attack being thrown by Doonbug here. Two Protect Shields remaining for Magic Mason. We see no Protect Shield as he matches Doonbug's Sky Attack for Sky Attack. Both Skarmories about an energy parity. I think Mason's just one or two Steel Wings ahead. Another Sky Attack coming through here.
I think this actually is a Brave Bird. I think I saw him click on the left side of the screen. Brave Bird not able to pick the knockout. Now Brave Bird coming from Doonbug. Magic Mason, I love this. No shield and going to try to get energy on whatever Pokemon he brings in. And
Undercharge
actually. Still picks up the knockout.
Still gets a knockout. In comes Dugong, and the Ice Shard takes care of the rest of the Skarmory. Now we've got Whiscash for Doonbug and a very weak Lickitung.
Lickitung is in the deep red. Whiscash will not like taking Icy Winds, but it needs to come in to prevent Magic Mason from locking in these attack buffs for the rest of the game.
We've seen so many Whiscash trainers do exactly this, right? Throw the Mud Bomb before the first Icy Wind applies. Protect Shield goes up there for Magic Mason. We're gonna see another Ice Shard get fired off, trying to throw on good timing, three Ice Shards, but before he can get to the next Icy Wind, Doonbug throws another Mud Bomb.
Opting for the timing of three Ice Shards instead of just one, I would have preferred one so he could get another Icy Wind off early. Now opting for unoptimal timing because if he continued to do Ice Shards, he might have overcapped himself.
Doonbug knows that the Shadow Whiscash can be so powerful, such an incredible closing Pokemon, but he's still got so much Dugong to chew through, and he's not throwing any charge attacks. He needs to start to put some damage on the board as another Icy Wind comes through, and no Protect Shield?
This is a bit of a risky call, meaning his final two Pokemon are both deep in the red, a switch into the Lickitung, but forcing an energy. Magic Mason is going to get a knocked, Magic Mason's Gligar is going to be knocked out here.
Yeah, this is a knockout onto the Gligar, but however, you want to get to the Power Whip on the Lickitung, you can't quite do that because you don't have enough HP to manage it. So instead, he goes for the Body Slam to chip down the Dugong. Now, again, with the charge attack intervals, Whiscash might have enough time with his residual energy to get to double Mud Bomb. It needs to do at least that, but look at this Dugong, it already has the Drill Run.
The question now becomes, will Dugong throw immediately? Actually, it looked like I couldn't tell. I don't know if that was one Mud Bomb or two Mud Bombs loaded. First one coming through, no debuffs remaining. Second Mud Bomb is loaded back to back, but this Icy Wind isn't going to be that impactful.
Yeah, Icy Wind gets Protect Shielded up here. Final Protect Shield for Doonbug in this game, and that's all he needs because the second Mud Bomb will pick up the knockout against the Water Ice type. Dugong going down here in Knoxville. Doonbug going up 2-0.
Magic Mason fighting back, but still not quite enough to take another game off of Doonbug. Doonbug keeping Mason at one win, keeping the entire field here in Knoxville at one singular game win.
Now, Doonbug has a chance here to make history. He will become the first North America trainer to win two regionals in the same season if he can defeat Magic Mason. He's one game away. However, we've seen so many reverse sweeps, so many comebacks in the championship series, even bracket resets. They're actually more frequent than there are bracket sweeps. So we could see a very exciting situation unfold, but Magic Mason needs to start fighting back. He's on the back heel, and even that sounds like an understatement.
And a bit of an interesting turn of events in the Skarmory mirror match. Magic Mason able to get a bit of an energy advantage. I would have really liked him to throw his energy in the Dugong versus Whiscash matchup earlier. earlier, but really good patience from Dewgong, building up a ton of mud bombs and ending the game after the Lickitung took out the Gligar with back-to-back mud bombs.
All right, we need everybody to get hyped in the chat. We've got Shadow Whiskash versus Shadow Gligar. This could be the decisive game number three of our grand finals in Knoxville. Shadow Whiskash, Shadow Gligar, technically a pretty close matchup, but the Scald can be so impactful. Gonna go for a quick aerial ace, Magic Mason.
Mud Shot's really not adding up to that much residual damage. Going for the Scald, waiting one turn to make sure the Scald lands on its intended target. I don't think this is going to be quite enough to knock out. We see the no shield, able to take it. Attack drops, reaching now for another aerial ace at the charge attack tie with a Mud Bomb.
Not only does he connect with the Scald, not only does he get the attack drop, but he also wins the charge attack priority tie. Shadow Whiskash for Dunebug has been a game changer.
Shield used by Magic Mason to ensure that this aerial ace does land on the Whiskash. Whiskash going to be able to barely take it, a simultaneous swap. How many times have we seen that at this event?
Annihilate for Dunebug hits the field versus the Whiskash for Magic Mason. Scald gets queued up here, but an early protection by Dunebug. You can see he looks a little confident there, kind of a slight smile, but he still needs to finish the job. No attack fall either. Here comes Annihilate.
Seems like he might be, not fishing for the Night Slash boost. I thought that's why he was smiling, thinking, if I boost again, that's gonna give me such a strong position in this game. Great shield for Magic Mason.
Final Protect Shield for Magic Mason gets spent on the Shadow Ball, a great call, but another Protect Shield up here for Dunebug as he shields up the second Scald. Do we get an attack fall? And we do not! Annihilate is just running through competition here in Knoxville. Another Shadow Ball from Dunebug.
Gotta call Dunebug a little bit of a Doombug, doing lots of damage with the Shadow Ball, able to take out the Whiskash, but in comes Magic Mason's Charge Bug, going to really struggle here. 3 Volt Switch, tries to catch. Great patience from Magic Mason. Another simultaneous swap.
Dunebug tries to make the cheeky swap onto his Whiskash, but here comes a Night Slash, maybe trying for one more boost to round things out here in Knoxville, Tennessee. Night Slash connecting into the Charge Bug. He says two, he wants another one. Then he gets it! Dunebug rolling in Knoxville.
Discharge required to be used here. X Scissor would be double resisted ghost and fighting type, able to get the knockout, but in the back is Lickitung, and you see Magic Mason sighing. It takes so many charge attacks to get through this Lickitung, and he stops tapping. He's recognized that this is it.
Magic Mason wanted the Skarmory, but we can't all have our dreams come true. Dunebug, meanwhile, fires the Power Whip. That is a 3-0 sweep in the Knoxville Grand Finals, and Dunebug becomes your back-to-back champion here in North America.
What incredible play by Dunebug. So consistent throughout this entire event, dropping just a singular game, able to get his second regional win within one season, the first person within North America.